Let's welcome Tiziana Di Matteo. Tiziana is Professor of Econometric Physics in the Department of Mathematics at King's College London. Her main research contributions are in econophysics, complex networks, and data science. She has well-known achievements, among others, in fractality of financial time series and data analytics with the help of a new type of network. Tiziana, here you are. Welcome on stage.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, thank you very much, Stefan, for this invitation. I'm very happy to be here today. You invited us to discuss the questions of complexity, where do we go from here? And I will try to answer and address these questions in the next few minutes. This is a big question, and to me, this translates in the questions. I probably used this. What is the future of complexity science? So, in few words, you are asking us to make a prediction of the complexity science, and this is really very hard and difficult. However, my answer to this is that it is better to stay where we are. And I will try to motivate my answer by answering other important questions that also Stefano was suggesting us to address. What makes complexity science unique? In my opinion, uniqueness of complexity science lies in the fact that it operates at crossing of different disciplines and it is interdisciplinary by its nature. And this has already been mentioned today by Vito, for example. And also, it is a big data science. And as also mentioned by Rosario this morning, complexity science is the science that studies complex systems. And as there is no unique and simple, a single definition of complexity or complex systems, in my opinion, there is not a single unique and more recommendable, advisable direction that should be pushed forward in our field to get further development. But each of us, in my opinion, should pursue their ongoing studies by leveraging on their own expertise, and we should empower our community. Also, in order to further progress in our field, in my opinion, we need to look at the data. We need to tackle real-world challenges where an impact can be emphasized. And we need to adopt approaches, tools that are data-driven by nature. And we need to work in an interdisciplinary team. Why it is essential that our scientific field exists? We have created the knowledge that has been proved to be relevant. We now need to create new knowledge. We need to look at what the data says, and we need to use this data to prioritize our next steps. I am a physicist. In the audience, there are so many other physicists. My interest is in economics and finance. So some of you might ask why physicists are interested in economics and finance. I can tell you that for sure it's not because famous physicists have been honored to have their pictures on currencies all around the world, but there are some more serious reasons. There has been a job market crisis, at least in Europe, together with a demographic loss, plus a lack of interest towards the physical sciences. But on the other side, there has also been a job market success. So bank financial institutions have begun to hire physicists and mathematicians in their companies. And there is this nice survey of 1997 by the UK Engineering and Physical Sciences Research Council that tells us that the financial sector is the major source of employment of people after 1 year of their PhD, and 48% of them are physicists and mathematicians. However, economics and finance are examples of complex systems, are rich of data, and physicists have been trained to look into the data. We usually propose models that are grounded by the empirical regularity evidences. So I'm sure we can create new knowledge in finance and economics. And in order, in my opinion, to create further new knowledge, we need to push forward the studies in the direction of developing better and new approaches to prediction and forecasting. We need to develop models where the number of parameters is reduced, and we need to use techniques that are scientifically testable. However, as also noted by Newton, after losing 20,000 pounds, I can calculate the motions of heavenly bodies, but not the madness of people. So a lot of care should be taken. And while economists deal with human behavior and prediction is more difficult than with matter, light, particles, and waves, while in physics one can reasonably expect that the physical reality to be studied doesn't change, in economics at best we find what can be called the persistence or long-range regularity of behaviors. And in my opinion, it's this regularity of behaviors that should pave the way for better prediction. Last question and answer is, how can we become more disruptive? Well, my answer to this is by making complexity science and investment science, by devoting more time, energies, effort, and money to make complexity science more groundbreaking and more disruptive. And this is more important than ever. Thank you very much.